Hi everyone, welcome to This Is My Architecture. I'm Jasmine and I have here with me Rahul Agrawal from MindTickle. Hi Rahul, thanks for joining us.
Hi Jasmine, thank you for having me over.
So tell us about MindTickle.
So MindTickle is the market leading sales readiness platform, helping revenue leaders at world-class companies such as Splunk, Wipro, Johnson & Johnson be ready to grow their revenue by increasing knowledge, understanding ideal sales behaviors and adapting to change. Today, dozens of Fortune 500 and Forbes Global 2000 companies use MindTickle to define excellence, build knowledge, align content, analyze performance, and optimize behaviors of the sales organizations.
That's amazing. So do you also have global presence?
Yeah, so we are currently present in two geographies, Asia and the US, and have an ability to quickly replicate into other geographies as well.
Okay, amazing. So let us look at your architecture.
Sure. So as soon as the user tries to access our platform, the request is routed to CloudFront. From the CloudFront, the request is then redirected to Lambda Edge. This is the place where we try to decide which region the user should be routed to based on where the user is trying to access the platform. From the Lambda, the request is then routed through Route 53. And that is where our DNS firewall is placed. That allows us to block any request that we don't want to come into this part of our infrastructure. From Route 53, the requests are routed through Application Load Balancer. And through that, the requests are then routed through the other microservices which are running into our Elastic Kubernetes service by AWS. And the microservices running in EKS cluster tries to access the databases, the AWS RDS that we use for our workflows.
So with global expansion, are you also able to replicate the environments across geographies?
Yes, so we are able to do that now. Earlier it used to be a lot of manual effort, but now we have tried to automate most of our workflows.
Okay. And what are those important considerations for the replication of the environment?
So for us, there are three important considerations, which is infrastructure, application, and data. So under the infrastructure automation, we leverage the help of AWS CloudFormation that helps us to maintain all the infrastructure as a code so that the infrastructure is replicable across the different geographies as and when required. For application automation, we leverage Helm charts and EKS, so as most of our microservices are deployed within EKS. For data automation, we use SQL and NoSQL databases, so we have a generic framework that we have built to automate the data as well. And the nature of the data here is mostly the templates and the master data, which is not related to the customer data at all. It is the data that is required for the functioning of our services.
So you spoke about data replication and how this is template or master data and not the customer data. Is that for compliance reason?
That's absolutely correct. This is for compliance reason because different state has different regulations where the data cannot leave the geography that they are in. And additionally, as you mentioned about the compliance, so we also ensure that the whole infrastructure here, which is through the DNS firewall, and ALBs, the EKS, the whole RDS databases that we're using. So this part of the architecture is completely replicated into different geographies, and we ensure through DNS firewall that none of the requests from different geographies are able to get into different regions as well, to ensure the complete isolation of the environment.
What were the challenges in this journey?
So as MindTickle grew a lot over the years, the system became a lot complex with more than 250 microservices and more than 1500 config variables to manage in each environment.
1500 config variables, wow, that's quite a complexity. And what are the benefits of this architecture?
So this architecture really helps us to replicate into different geographies very quickly. And with this, we were able to replicate around 95 to 98% of our infrastructure, allowing us to access markets in different geographies as well.
So you are able to achieve 95 to 98% of automation. Wow. And with the kind of business that we have these days, which are extremely agile, right, and the features completely agile, it's great that you are able to achieve 95% of automation. So just curious, how did your journey start? Was it always with automation, or did it start in a manual fashion?
So it was obviously not always automation. It was mainly manual earlier. You know, it was always the rigorous effort from different teams coming together and ensuring that the environment is up. It used to take around 6 to 8 months earlier to replicate the whole environment. Yeah.
Okay. So that time it took 6 to 8 months, and now how long does it take if you have to replicate complete environment into different geography?
So now I think from 6 to 8 months to now 1 day. So that is the time that we were able to reduce, and that really allows us to, you know, quickly you know, go into different geographies if needed, where the customers are located, and ensuring that all the regulations of the state.
That's really amazing. Thanks, Rahul, for sharing this architecture with us.
Thank you.
Thanks, everyone, for watching This Is My Architecture.